Welcome to Littlefield University. Today we're going to be talking about filming interviews. Check it out. Interviews are the bread and butter of video production. There's a good chance if you're watching this that you've probably had to film an interview for a client at some point. And if not, I guarantee you will someday. At our production house, the Littlefield Company, we shoot interviews all the time. And you know, we're lucky enough to have access to a lot of professional equipment, which definitely makes things easier. So if we kind of take a step back here, you can see the equipment that we're working with. We're shooting two cameras so that we can cut back and forth in the edit. And that helps trim out, you know, a lot of the excessive pauses and stumbles, uhs and ums. Both angles are being filmed with the Canon C500 cinema camera using Canon Cine Prime lenses. We've got a 50 millimeter lens on A cam, and we've got an 85 millimeter lens here on B cam. You can see our A cam is planted firmly on a tripod, but we've got the B cam over here on the syrup slider, and that helps get a little bit of dynamic camera movement in the shot. It's not entirely necessary, but it does add a nice touch and production value to the final video. Of course, it doesn't matter what camera you're using if the subject isn't lit well. Lighting is arguably the most important aspect of crafting beautiful visuals. So this right here is our key light, and the key light is just the main light source in your scene. For our key, we are firing an aperture 600D into a beadboard and then through an 8x silk diffusion, which is a very fancy way of saying that we are bouncing light off of a foam board through a white cloth in an 8x8 frame. Now, the reason we do this is to double diffuse the light. When that happens, we're giving an ultra soft light onto our subject, which is just more pleasing to the eye than a more direct source of light. Now, depending on your interview, you may want to light your subjects differently. For example, if they're talking about a particularly heavy subject, you might want to moodier setup, that it's a little bit darker and has more harsh shadows. But for most of the interviews that we shoot, they are brand films and marketing videos, so it's a pretty safe bet to just light our subjects with a big, bright, soft light. And that's what the 8x silk is for. Now, you might also notice that I've got a little bit of a reflection here in my glasses. Glasses are notoriously difficult to light for, and due to the limitations of the space that we're in, we can't really get this light anywhere else. But one way to kind of get around reflections in your glasses is you can use a polarizing filter on your lens, or you can just raise the light up until it's not in your glasses anymore, which again, we just can't do because we're already tapped out at the ceiling. So I like to think of lighting and diffusion in terms of the sun. On a clear, sunny day, when you look down at your shadow, you're gonna see really crisp, defined edges. And that's what would happen here if our light didn't have any diffusion. If we weren't using the silk or the beadboard, that light would be insanely bright and the shadows on my face would be really harsh. But on an overcast day, you look down, your shadows are gonna be soft and diffused. And interviews tend to look more flattering with soft lighting and diffused shadows. So by bouncing the light off the beadboard, it's gonna diffuse that harsh light, and then the silk diffuses it even more. Now, you'll also notice that the light is coming in from the side here and not from the front. Front lighting usually results in a flat image, which is fine in some cases. But in order to make the image look a little more cinematic, we are always looking for ways to create depth and dimension in the frame. So by placing the light off to the side, it casts a little bit of a shadow on this side of my face, and it helps create that three-dimensional image. And it also helps define cheekbones and jawlines if you are lucky enough to have those. And again, it just helps make the subject look more flattering. Now, if your shadows on the side of your face are too dark, you can add a light on the opposite side of the key light, and that's called the fill light, and it's just there to fill in shadows. But remember, you don't want to fill them in too much because we want to keep that depth and dimension. You don't necessarily need another light here. You could just add a reflector or even a piece of white poster board to just bounce the light from the key into the darker side of your subject's face. Now, of course, an interview wouldn't be very useful if you can't hear anything, so audio is obviously a crucial part of this process. We are running the Rode NTG3 shotgun microphone directly into our Canon C500, which is one of the best features of a cinema camera like this because we can monitor and mix audio as needed right there on the back of the camera. We've mounted this boom pole to a C-stand over here so that no one has to, you know, lift their arms over their head for the whole video. And you'll also notice that right here I've got a lavalier microphone clipped to my shirt, and that is recording audio over to our B-cam. Personally, I feel like boom audio tends to sound better, but it's always a good idea to have backup audio that you can use just in case. So this is how we typically approach shooting interviews. Of course, each new shoot comes with unique challenges, and when that happens, we have to think on our feet, we have to get creative. What happens if you don't have access to this much equipment, right? Is it possible to achieve a similar look and feel with budget gear and DIY alternatives? No. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. No, yes, of course it is, and we're gonna show you how we do that. For our cameras in this shoot, we are using the Canon 5D Mark III. Now, this is a great starter camera if you are just getting into freelance videography. We're using DSLR lenses, and you know we're still on the syrup slider here, but you don't need to use that. You can certainly just have an A cam and a B cam. You can just use an A cam if that's all you have access to. So this is just a can light that you would find at Lowe's or Home Depot. They are less than $10. And I have put some parchment paper on front of it so that you can kind of diffuse the lighting. And we're using this to just kind of fill in some of the light in the background so it doesn't get too dark. So I'm gonna turn that on now. And there you go. So nice soft diffuse light from a $10 light that you can get at Home Depot. So this is an old school studio light from Lowell Pro. You can get them super cheap on eBay, things like that. It is a hot light, so it puts off a lot of heat, so be careful, wear gloves if you have to. The nice part about this is that it has barn doors on the front, so you can actually shape that light. But I'm gonna use this as a hair light, so I'm gonna raise this up and point it to where I was sitting on the stool. All right, striking.
So here we have our key light, which is just a GMV LED light. I think it was around $120 on Amazon. And we have our Godox diffusion right here. And we're basically just gonna raise this up to a point where we won't see the reflection in Mike's glasses. But we're gonna set it up at about a 45 degree angle to his face so we don't have a harsh shadow on one side. And we'll adjust as we turn on the cameras. Here we have our reflector. This is just a simple, I also don't know what it's used for. We got it at Lowe's, it's around $20. It's got a white on one side for bouncing light off of, and then if we need a little more power, we have the reflective shiny side. All we're doing is we're getting on the other side of our key light, and we're just gonna angle it perfectly so it hits Mike's face on his left side where it's a little darker, just to bring up the level on that side. So this is our audio setup. We have is a Rode VideoMic Pro, and we have an extension cable that is running into our Canon 5D, and we are gonna clean this up. This will help get much clearer audio than if it was just mounted on your camera. Gets us about a foot away from his mouth, and we'll get some nice crisp audio that way.
So as you can see, this still looks really good. Obviously, you have to think a little differently when you don't have access to the newest and brightest lights or a $15,000 cinema camera or cinema lenses. Obviously, the sound isn't as crystal clear as it was before. But if you're freelancing, you're just getting started, the end product is still pretty great quality. Ultimately, we wanted to show you some basic principles of how to shoot an interview. Once you know the basics, you can use cheap stuff, you can use expensive stuff. Either way, these techniques are universal and should be a good starting point for your next interview. Okay, so there you go, an interview setup on a budget. Let us know what you think by leaving a comment below. If you enjoyed the video, do me a favor and give it a like. Subscribe to the channel, and of course, hit the bell icon to get notifications when we post new videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in class.